All right, it is opening day, and we have got live reports coming from Wrigley Field, where the Cubs will take on the Brewers at 1:20 this afternoon.
I don't know about you, but in the back of my head, you know that tune. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. That's right. Excitement is building and crowds are gathering despite the cold and the weather. Heck, that has not stopped us, and we're not letting that dampen our game.
Of course,
spirit.
The two of us are inside, so it makes a little bit of a difference.
Hey, I'm a little bit jealous of Tom and Larry who are out there enjoying the day, enjoying the crowd, but we're going to go out to them in a little bit here. But hey, I'm Christine Flores.
And I'm Chip Brewster, so thanks for joining us. This brief little live stream we're going to bring you, a special edition of WGN News Now. Now, as Christine mentioned, we have got special team coverage for you.
Our Larry Hawley is inside of the ballpark with a preview of the game, and our Tom Barnas is live outside of the ballpark with more of that fan vibe. Let's see if they can hear us from out there. Hey, Larry.
Hey, guys, how are you? Welcome to beautiful opening day here at Wrigley Field. Now, I say beautiful because opening day is always awesome, but the weather is actually pretty typical for Wrigley Field. Most of the time, it's usually cold, and in fact, over the last couple minutes, we've even had a couple of snow flurries. You might be able to see them on the camera. So here's a look at the ballpark right now. As you can see, very overcast, very gray. You know what? To be honest with you, this is usually what opening day is like. The last time I was here for a Cubs opening day was actually 2003, and that was actually after the game was snowed out the day before.
Oh, yeah.
So it's used to having snow. I was also here on opening day 1998 when it was freezing cold. That was, of course, the day which the Cubs had a tribute to Harry Carey, who had passed away just a couple of months ago. Now, despite the weather, which frankly is pretty typical, there's still a lot of excitement about the Cubs getting a chance to start. And a lot of intrigue about this team, since very, very frankly, there's a lot of new pieces to it.
Yep.
But there is one consistent thing about the Cubs today, and that is their battery, and that includes starting pitcher Kyle Hendricks.
Mm-hmm.
Hendricks will take the mound for his third consecutive opening day. Kyle did so in 2020 in the shortened season. That was in July, so it was nice and warm and sunny that day, and Hendricks was outstanding that evening. He threw a complete game shutout as the Cubs would go on to win the National League Central Division that year. Not quite as good in 2021 when the Cubs could only have limited capacity. He only lasted a couple innings as the Cubs lost to the Pirates. And last year in general was actually a pretty tough year for Hendricks. His ERA was over 4. He struggled giving up homers. His record was still 14-7, but not the Kyle Hendricks that people have gotten used to here at Wrigley Field. A pitcher who is known for his control, known for walking. So really interesting to see kind of how he bounces back this year. But again, a lot of things coming up here about the Cubs, a lot of different elements. We're going to see what Seiya Suzuki can do. Marcus Stroman's going to pitch here on Saturday. He's really endeared himself to Cubs fans, and some might say he could be the new face of the franchise. There's also other things. Can Patrick Wisdom and Frank Schwindel keep up what they were doing toward the end of last year and maybe give the Cubs something to rely on as far as consistency goes? And then, of course, there is Nick Madrigal, who came over from the White Sox. He missed most of last year. What is he going to be able to do at second base? And how will Nico Horner be able to go ahead and contribute in the middle of the infield as well? Lots of questions for the Cubs. Of course, we do talk a lot about that rotation as well. We'll get to that with the guests coming up in a little bit. But let's take a look at a few facts here for this opening day. This will be the third time the Cubs will be opening in a row at home. Now, that's a little bit different. Remember when the Cubs were doing all the repairs for the Project 1060? The Cubs are really away from home from 2016 through 2019. They didn't open the season here at home. They were always opening on the road. In fact, 2019, they actually began, if I'm not mistaken, with 9 consecutive road games before finally coming back here to Wrigley Field. This is also the fifth time that the Cubs will face a Milwaukee team here for opening day. It's only happened 4 times before. 2 came when the Milwaukee Braves, now the Atlanta Braves, when they called Milwaukee home, they actually opened with the Cubs in 1956 and 1957. We mentioned 2020, the Cubs opening up with the Brewers. The Cubs also opened up 2008 with the Brewers. Many fans will remember that game because Kosuke Fukudome hit a dramatic 3-run homer in the 9th inning to tie the game. Unfortunately, the Cubs would go on to lose that contest. In fact, the Cubs would not beat a Milwaukee team on opening day until 2020 when Kyle Hendricks had that shutout. Now, one of the players who has been here all this time has been Jason Hayward, the consistent outfielder and Gold Glove winner, is one of those who's very excited to have the capacity back to 100% here at Wrigley Field. And he's also very encouraged by the team as well. Here's what he had to say in the locker room about an hour ago.
The first time in a couple of years to have 100% capacity opening day, and like you said, wouldn't be Wrigley without a little weather. I think you have a group of guys who are very eager and hungry to see what it's like to put this uniform on a daily basis and play for this fan base. You know, most of these guys coming in this year, I think it's unique because I want to say a lot, like 15. You know, a lot of them are coming from other places. They've heard about the Cubbies. They've seen, you know, some special things. But I think this year, guys are hungry just to see what that's about. Come in, have their moments, a lot like you saw in the second half last year. But I think there's a new sense of expectation for us to come in, hold each other accountable, have fun, but play some winning baseball.
All right, guys. Well, that is Jason Hayward. He's going to be one of those players who is back. There are not a lot of those guys who are back from the original core. As we mentioned a few times, I mentioned on WGNTV.com, and the fact is, very simply, that most of the core was traded away last July. That includes Chris Bryant, Anthony Rizzo, Javier Baez. So much of a new-look Cubs team this year. And what that means is a lot of questions about where the club is going. What's the record going to be in 2022? What's David Ross going to be like, considering this is his first true year? Well, on WGN News Now Sports Talk, which is a segment that we have exclusively on WGNTV.com, we talked to Megan Montemurro about that. She talked about a number of topics, and she began with the outfielder, Seiya Suzuki. Here's what she had to say on the News Now Sports Talk this week about what she may be expecting and really is looking forward to as the Cubs begin their season today.
Things, which is a good thing for them, given how much they invested in him, is Seiya Suzuki. I mean, getting a glimpse of him the past couple of weeks and just not only seeing the adjustments he makes at bat, but just watching his swing, seeing how the ball pops off of it. He clearly has some effortless power that should play very well at Wrigley once he makes the adjustments that the Cubs expect him to eventually make. Obviously, they're anticipating a little bit of a transitionary period coming over from Japan, seeing a lot more different types of pitchers. And then on the flip side, you know, he will have more data. He already said that, you know, what he has at his disposal data-wise is a lot more than what he had in Japan. So that should also help. But yeah, I mean, obviously for first few signs of him, I mean, he has great potential, great eye at the plate. He has the chance to be very impressive. And then I think the other thing is, you look at the top of the rotation is really intriguing. I mean, you have Kyle Hendricks, who has talked a lot about how he wants to bounce back from last year. It clearly wasn't up to his standard. You have Marcus Stroman, obviously, coming in. He has a good history and is looking to establish himself up at the top with Hendricks there. And then they have some intriguing guys like Justin Steele, who gets the game two start on Friday, as well as bringing in guys like Drew Smyly and Wade Miley, who the latter is going to end up on the IL to start the season. But there's some interesting pieces there. So, you know, given how that rotation looked last year and over the course of the season, some of the struggles that group had collectively, you know, they really need to set the tone early this season, especially, you know, cold weather isn't usually very conducive for hitters. So they really need, you know, the rotation to step up early for them.
And big thanks to Megan for taking some time out before opening day. You can see her full interview right now at WGNTV.com. Just click on the WGN News Now page. And Chip, just as I go ahead and say that, it has started snowing a little bit here again. Wouldn't be opening day without Wrigley Field, inside without it, and having all the snow go through. Hey, it's opening day. This is what it's all about. But that's it right now from inside the ballpark. Guys, let's go back to you.
But you know what that means? It's starting to snow. Be a little bit colder. That means it's time to go inside. Go inside one of those bars. Tom Barnas, you actually have a glimpse of what that looks like for some people. What's it like?
Including himself.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm just enjoying myself. I see the snowflakes starting to happen out there, and I gotta tell you, I don't feel bad for Larry because he's got a great view. But the one thing that I definitely need to talk about, I don't know if you guys have ever seen the movie Major League. But in the movie Major League, at the beginning of the movie, they talk about whether or not anybody knows this team and people are excited. And that's kind of the vibe outside of Wrigley. Here inside Murphy's is where I'm at now, where a lot of people are asking, I don't know who any of these guys are, but I'm excited to watch them play.
Yeah.
But I thought I'd give you guys a little look-see of Murphy's. But check that out. Do you see that up there in the corner, that old-school WGN banner?
Like,
check that out. Autographed by Harry Carey and Jack Brickhouse and some of the old production crew at WGN years ago. But I thought I'd take you for a little walk through Murphy's because it might be empty in the ballpark, but it's definitely not empty inside Murphy's. It's nice and busy. It's cozy in here. The beer's flowing. And you know what, guys? Every year we talk about whether or not the Cubs are going to be good, if they're going to make it to the World Series. Mm-hmm. And the one thing that's the one thing that's always changing, right? The Cubs never are a sure thing. But you know what is a sure thing in Wrigleyville is the bars. So we're here at Murphy's, and as you can see, it's packed. Hey, how you fellas doing? How you doing?
How you doing? We're about to have a year, baby. We're back.
Yeah. What kind of year are we having this year? What do you expect out of our Cubbies?
Minimum 80 wins. I think we're
80 wins? Oh, really? 80
wins this year. 500 ball. Get it back. Give Jed a bit of time to get the team back together. The 2026 World Series champions climb up to the top.
Do you have that same sentiment? You think you're going to do 80 wins?
I'll take my son's advice. He's pretty good. He just 80. Won 3 out of 5 pools in the finals. So.
All right. So if you're placing your bets, what's the over-under in the Cubs this year?
I mean, it's got to be at what, 71 and a half with all the books? I'd hammer the over.
All right. I'll take it. Thank you
very
much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So, yeah, that's the vibe happening here inside Murphy's. I'm going to walk outside if you guys want me to.
Sure,
I'll brave the elements for the sake of television. But real quick, I just got to show this because this is the best part about Murphy's.
Yes.
They have a hot dog stand inside the bar. If you've never been inside Murphy's before, you got to come by.
Love
because
it.
The hot dogs are going. We had Dean Richards out here earlier giving away some Vienna beef, but now you can come inside, grab a burger, some dogs, the whole thing. But this place is packed. It feels like old school opening day. It's a lot of fun in here. But now, here comes the tough part of the job. I'm going to follow this young lady outside, and you'll probably hear me a lot better. And these people are amazing. Look at this.
Wow.
It's freezing out here. It's kind of snowing. Are you guys going to hang out? Snow, sleet, the whole thing?
Doesn't matter if a blizzard hits, we're here.
There you go.
Doesn't matter if there's a blizzard, we're hitting opening day today.
In the same spot, you're not moving. There's not even an umbrella. What about the awnings? Did you tell them to get these awnings
Don't
down or what?
It. Bring on the weather. We want all of it. We want all of it. It's opening day. Nothing's getting in the way.
All right, Brave Cub fans, thank you very much, everybody. Hey, excuse me, miss. How are the beer sales happening today?
Oh, they're popping.
They're
it's
popping?
Nice and cold.
You guys are out here, rain, shine, snow, sleet, the whole thing, right?
Yeah, we got it. Do what we gotta do.
Awesome. So we got some old style on tap for $7, and we got
tap.
Some.
They're all in cans.
Oh, I'm sorry, in cans. But well, thank you. You're gonna be out here all day.
Hopefully.
Hopefully all day, whether or not it rains or not, guys. People are going to hang out, so I'm just going to walk down a ways here just because. Have you guys ever been to Murphy's before?
I have, and it is a fun time, and I'm so glad to see just that environment get back up again. I mean, like you were showing us, Tom, just people are excited to be out again and excited for this opening day, so I can just imagine what the atmosphere is like there. It just seems so much fun.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun inside, and outside it's starting to buzz a little bit. You can see I'm right here. Look at all the Cub fans lined up. I'm going to walk down here a little bit because you can see I'm right at the intersection of Sheffield and Waveland. So this is where all the balls are hit when there's home runs. You see that down there, guys? All these 11 gates open at 11:20. So these are all the bleacher fans waiting to get in the ballpark. And
perfect.
They're braving the elements out here. So that's the scene happening outside here at Wrigley. It's a good time. It's good to have opening day back. I'm excited for it.
Beautiful. Well, Tom, we appreciate you taking the time to step outside of the bar. Both of you guys here, we'll bring Larry back in too, just because he's been standing by
there
inside the field as well. Is there anything that either of you needed to say to one another, Larry to Tom, perhaps?
Well, Tom, you've said you've been going to games for a number of years, so happy opening day to you. I know what it means to you to see the Cubs. I know it's an unusual time for the Cubs because there's so much news after what happened at the trade deadline last year. As I'm sure you and a lot of other people are used to this kind of weather, it's snowing, it's cold. That's Chicago in early April. That's Wrigley Field in early April, with a couple of nice exceptions. You know, we thought of 2019. But I think, as for you, I share in the joy that things are about as back to normal as they can be. 100% full capacity for the first time since 2009. Reporters are being let back into the clubhouse again. So that's something that's very different and unique about the 2022 season. So happy opening day, Tom. I hope you enjoy it. I know you're probably having a lot of fun at Murphy's. And as you can see, despite it being a little cloudy, it still is a beautiful venue. It's still exciting. And it's still baseball with 162 full games. It didn't look like that about a month ago, but indeed, here we are, just a little bit of a delay. Opening day ended up being just 3 days later, here at Wrigley Field, that is, and the season was only delayed about a week. So, Tom, happy opening day.
Larry, happy opening day to you. And from what I remember, you telling me this is your first opening day at Wrigley Field in a long time, since what, like the mid-90s?
So 2003 was the last opening day. I covered it for WICD-TV in Champaign. I got to go because the previous game got snowed out, so the person who was supposed to go couldn't go, so I came here with my camera. I remember doing the stand-up in the dugout. It was a dream come true. It always is for me, as somebody who grew up watching Channel 9, to be here live on the field. It's something incredibly special. So many people helped to make this happen. But it really brings back a lot of memories. I remember the late Ernie Banks and Sammy Sosa throwing out the first pitch. I remember talking to Billy Williams. I remember it snowing as I got video of Mark Pryor throwing in the bullpen. He was doing some towel exercises in the bullpen. Matt Clement started
the famous towel exercises.
The towel exercises, he did that. Clement pitched in there. I think they won the game 6-1. And I think Clement either pitched the next day or the day after. I'm just trying to remember exactly. But it's been a long time. I haven't been here for a long time. But it is fitting, though, that it's cold and it's a little snowy. I wouldn't have it any other way.
Sure.
Yeah, you know what the funny thing is? I don't know if you guys realize this, but we complain every year. Well, some people complain every year about how cold it is on opening day. Because I'm not going to lie, it's not great, but it's cold and it's sleeting and snowing. But we wouldn't be complaining right now if this was a Bears game. We would be like, this is warm.
So
this is beautiful.
Oh, right? This is perfect fair weather, actually. This would be ideal.
Well, yeah, so if you just put yourself in that mindset, you're good, right?
Yeah.
Well, yep, Tom, no. Just think of it as beautiful pear weather and tolerable cub weather.
Yes.
Yeah.
There we go. Tom and
yes,
Larry, thank you guys
tolerable
so much.
For sure. You're welcome, guys.
You.
Happy opening day.
Stay warm out there.
Happy opening day.
Go inside and enjoy the crowd for us.
Yeah, get a hot dog.
And, you know, speaking of crowds, I'm sure some of those people had to get some kind of a pass, maybe call in sick. I mean, I hope their bosses didn't just see them.
Right, we did just live stream out a whole bunch of people from inside Murphy's. Well, there are ways to get around the punishment, as it would be, and the Cubs, in fact, have hooked you up with a pass of sorts.
Yeah, this is a letter to excuse an absence from school, work, or anything else. The letter says it's been more than 1,000 days since the last true opening day at Wrigley. They even throw in a line to try and get everyone else the day off, too.
Since we'll all be unavailable for the afternoon and an integral contributor, perhaps everyone at this place should take the day. Oh, yes. Oh, I love it. You know what I would really like to see?
Yes.
Someone actually use it with success. Well, you have to have the right kind
proof,
of boss, right? Yeah, we need proof. But you have to know that your boss is a big Cubs fan when you go and bring them that letter.
Yeah, let us know if you use this, if it worked. Maybe it didn't work. Who knows? But you know what? Besides that, happy opening day and excited to see our Cubs out there today.
That's right. And against the Brewers, too. Mm-hmm. A nice little local rivalry to begin the season with.
Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Christine Flores.
I'm Chip Brewster. Happy opening day, everybody. Woo!